better known as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, was one of the most distinguished scientists of India. As he was intimately involved in India's civilian space program and military missile development effort, he came to be known as the Missile Man of India. In 2002, he was elected as the 11th President of India and was widely referred to as the People's President.
Yes, thank you.
Now write the words to find difficult for you. Can you explain the meaning of that word?
Distinguished is an adverb, and the meaning of the word distinguished is to be very successful, to be an admired person.
Mahatma Gandhi was a distinguished person. Vivekananda was a distinguished person. The person who has achieved a lot in his life, who is a very successful person in his life, who is a very famous person in his life, he is distinguished. Your father, Jayashree's father, is a distinguished person. Our principal is a distinguished person. The principal of Panpos College is also a distinguished person. So generally, we call distinguished when a person is very much successful, achieved and very famous, well known to others. So now you can write a sentence using distinguished. Who can make a sentence using distinguished? Anybody who can make a sentence using distinguished? Yes, you can. Yes, yes.
Ma'am, Mendel is distinguished as father of genetics.
Yes.
Mendel is distinguished as father of genetics.
Yes. Mendel is distinguished as father of genetics. She said Mendel was a scientist and Mendel discovered some scientific truth and he conducted research on peach, garden peach. So Mendel is distinguished as a scientist. You can write.
Like Ashok and Vishwajan sitting intimately to each other.
Yes. Ashoka and Vishwajit as sitting intimately each other. That means very close. Jayashri and Misrani are intimate to each other, or they are intimately related to each other. So intimately means closely related to each other. Intimate friends. We are saying that Prasanta and Vikas are intimate friends, and they are intimately related to each other. So who can make a sentence using intimately? Who can make a sentence using intimately? Anybody who can?
Roses and thorns are related intimately.
Roses and
thorns. Thorns, not
thorns. Roses and thorns are related intimately to each other. So now you can write a sentence using intimately. So all of you must write the sentences in your notebook.
Algebra and geometry are intimately related.
Algebra and geometry in mathematics are intimately. Very good sentence. The information the students must get that algebra is also a part of the mathematics. Geometry is also a part of the mathematics. Very good. Then involved.
Now we are all involved in the classroom. We are concerned about the teaching going on here.
Any example?
We can involve ourselves in study, and we can involve in playing.
Good. Teachers should encourage students to be involved in the teaching process. Students should get involved in the teaching learning process, in the classroom process. Children should be involved in the family work, family function. So that is, involved means participate or concern, to participate or to concern or taking part. So in classroom, the children should be involved in the learning process. So now, who can make a sentence using involved? Who can make a sentence using involved? Yes. Puspa. Pasai dio. Students must be involved in extracurricular activity. Besides curricular activity, besides study, we must play, we must sing, or so many extracurricular activities the schools are conducting, so students must be involved in extracurricular. Any word you find from the paragraph 1? Any more word?
No.
Thank you. So this much word they have from the paragraph 1. Now you can take your papers, group 2. You can come. Yes. You read the second paragraph. Hold the book like this. No.
Dr. Abdul Kalam was born on 15th October 1931 in a Tamil Muslim family at Rameshwaram in the state of Tamil Nadu. His father, Jainalakshin, was a boat owner.
Be slow. Try to give attention to different punctuation mark, full stop, comma. Be slow.
Owner and the imam of.
You can read like this. Dr. Abdul Kalam was born on 15th October 1931 in a Tamil Muslim family at Rameshwaram in the state of Tamil Nadu. His father, Jainaluddin, was a boat owner and imam of a local mosque.
His mother, Asina, was a housewife. His father owned a ferry that took Hindu pilgrims back and forth between Rameshwaram and Dhanushkodi.
Mishra, you come, you read the remaining portion.
Kalam was the youngest of four brothers and one sister in his family. His ancestors had been wealthy traders and landowners, but in course of time the family fell on hard times and lost their properties. Even their sisters. By his early childhood, the family had already become poor. Kalam had to sell newspaper to supplement his family's income.
Thank you. Write the word, meaning of the words, as Miss Rani. You take picture. You write the words and she will write the meaning and explain one by one. First word is muscule. You can explain the word, meaning of the word muscule.
Muscule means a religious place of Muslims. Mosque means a religious place which used by Muslim people.
Yes, you can ask to make sentences. You can make sentences.
Muslim people goes to mosque every Friday.
Mosque means a religious place just like temple of Hindu. We go to temple, Jagannath temple. We go to different temples of different god and goddesses. Similarly, the Muslim peoples, they go to mosque to pray to God. So that is a religious place of Muslims. That is also a religious place of Hindu. All the temples, all the mosques, all the churches and all the religious places are for all the peoples. For all the peoples. So mosque is also a religious place for peoples. Not only Muslim peoples, we also give respect to persecuted. So, who can make a sentence?
There is a mosque in front of my home.
Yes, there is a mosque in front of his home. There is a mosque in front of my home. Anybody who can make a sentence?
The structure of the mosque is very nice.
The structure of the mosque is very nice. So anybody? You can write. You can write. Yes.
Ma'am, Abdul visited the mosque for his mother's speed recovery.
Yes. Abdul Kalam visited the mosque for the recovery of his mother. You can write a sentence. Yes. Ferry is a boat. Ferry is a boat which carry people from one side of the river to the other side of the river. Usually when the people want to come across the river, most of the time the ferry is available, that boat is available. And that boat carry people from that village to other side of the river. That is what ferry is used to carry people from one side of the river to other side of the river. So most of the time people of village use ferry to cross the river. Most of the time people use ferry to cross the river. So who can make a sentence?
There is a lot of ferry in Chilika.
Yes, there is a lot of ferry in Chilika because travelers are going to Chilika and to visit that place. That is a very nice place. Travelers are going to that place regularly. So they are using ferry to go to Kalijai, to go to mountainside, or to go to other side of the Chilika. They use ferry. So now you can write sentence.
Ferry.
Yes. Ferry sells on the
water.
Then the next word.
The next word is owner. That means holder. Suppose this jug, I pay for this jug. That means I am the owner of this jug. This jug is possessed to me. This is my jug. So, this is owner.
Yes. Owner is a person who owns a particular thing or object. House owner, who owns a house. Land owner, who owns a land. So, that is the holder. You can write, you can make a sentence using owner. Ranjita, can you make a sentence using owner? Yes. My father, she is saying that, say loudly, my father is the owner of my house, our house. My father is the owner of my house. Yes. Thank you. Then the next one.
Ancestor.
ancestor.
A person of a family who lived for a long time. That means our father and father's father. He also an ancestor for us. That means in case of our mother, my mother's mother, or then our mother's, she also ancestor for us.
Where are you from?
I come from Bargad.
Bargad. Bargad is the ancestral place of Vikas. Where are you from?
I am from Sundargarh.
Yes.
I am from Sundargarh.
Sundargarh, which village?
I am from Tangarjar.
Tangar, Bali.
Jor.
Tangarjar. Your parents are living there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. That is the ancestral village of your parents?
Yes, ma'am.
Your grandparents are also living there?
Yes.
So, where is your place?
Bamra.
Bamra. Your parents are living there? That is also the
ancestral
place of your grandparents?
Yes, ma'am.
So, Bamra is the ancestral village of Prasanna. Tangarjor is the ancestral village of
Atish.
Atish. Tangarjor is the ancestral village of Atish. Bargad is the ancestral village of Vikas. Bamra is the ancestral place of
Prasanna.
So the place where the grandparents, they are living for a long period of time. That is known as ancestral. So who can make a sentence using ancestral? Who can make a sentence using ancestral? Have you all understood the meaning of ancestral?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Puri is my ancestral place because my parents were living there and my grandparents are also living there and their parents are also living there. So that is my ancestral
place.
So anybody who can make a sentence using Mahendra?
Angul is my ancestral city.
Yes. We should follow the path of our
ancestors.
Because they are also the great persons for us. Our parents, our grandparents, they are also the great persons for
us.
In our family, in our ancestors. So we should follow the path of our ancestors. Then you read your sentence. Babur was one of the ancestors of Mughal Empire. Then the next word.
Trader is a person who buys and sells things as a job.
Yes. You explain the meaning.
Means trader is a person whose job is only to buy and things from the people.
Yes. Any example can you give?
Mukesh Ambani is a successful trader.
Mukesh Ambani is a successful
trader.
Mukesh Ambani is a successful trader who is buying and selling technology. Who is buying and selling many types of technology. So you will find many traders in Rourkela. You will find many traders in your Rourkela market. You can also find many traders in Ambani. You can, small traders are there and big traders are also there. Those who are big selling and buying, they are big traders. Big shops and those who have small shops, they are also traders. They are also doing the same work, buying and selling. So, traders is a person. Is known as trader because he is a person who is selling and buying. Then, who can make a sentence using they are writing? What sentence you are writing?
Mukesh Ambani is a successful trader.
Yes, who Mukesh Ambani is a successful leader. Very good sentence. Thank you. Then the next one.
Housewife.
My mother was a housewife. Can you explain?
A woman who involves in housework. The best example is our mother. She doing all things in our house.
Joyce's mother is a housewife. Miss Rani's mother is also a housewife. My mother was also a housewife. But I am doing the both the work. I am also a housewife and I am also a
teacher.
Working woman. I am also a
working woman.
So anybody who can make a sentence using housewife? What sentence? Make it up. So anybody who can make a sentence?
Most of the women are housewives.
Most of the women of our country are housewives. Most of the women of our country are housewives. Yes.
Housewife works for 24 hours without payment.
Yes. Housewives are working for 24 hours. Thank you. Very good sentence. So now, these are some of the words. We find those words as difficult and the meaning and the sentence, then you go. Then the group 3.
APJ Abdul Kalam, full name is Abul Pakir Jainulabdin Kalam.
Abdul Kalam is Abdul Pakir Kalam.
Abdul Kalam was a former president.
Yes. Abdul Kalam was the most distinguished scientist of India.
Who was Abdul Kalam? Abdul Kalam was the most distinguished scientist of India. In your book, it is mentioned. What is mentioned in your book?
Missile Man of India.
Abdul Kalam was one of the most distinguished scientists of India.
Yes, he was also the president. And later it will come, he was a distinguished scientist. You come, Nandita. You ask some questions, you read the questions and ask some questions. You read the questions and ask.
Why
he was known as Missile Man of India?
Missiles,
which are used by army forces. That is why in both the war, in space war and also in preparing the missile, so Abdul Kalam was involved. That is why he was called as Missile Man. Then the next question.
What was he widely referred?
What was, you go through the books, the answer is in the last line of the first. Miss Rani, you tell.
He was widely referred to as the people's president.
He was widely referred to as a people's president because peoples of India very much loved Abdul Kalam, and always he thought of the people, always he wanted to work for the people, always he wanted to dedicate his life for the people of India in different war. That is why he widely described as known as people's president. As his life was dedicated for the people, that is why he was known as people's
president.
Okay, thank you. Any more question? Yes.
In which year he elected as president of India?
Can get the
yes,
Mahendra.
In 2002 he was elected as the president of India.
Yes.
Ma'am, in 2002 he was elected as the 11th president of India. India.
Okay. You tell again. You tell about the theme of the first paragraph. What the first paragraph was about? What the first paragraph was about? Yes, very good. Ranjita, you take Abdul Kalam. She said Abdul Kalam was a distinguished scientist. You take. Yes, the first paragraph was about Abdul Kalam's biography. The first paragraph was about Abdul Kalam's achievement and award. First paragraph was about Abdul Kalam's, how Abdul Kalam was a successful person. Abdul Kalam was a scientist. Abdul Kalam was our president. Abdul Kalam was also the missile man. That means here there are three contributions relating to his life. Abdul Kalam was a scientist. He prepared missiles and spacecraft. That is why he was a distinguished scientist. And Abdul Kalam was our president, and he was widely loved by, popularly loved by the peoples of India. That is why he was known as the people's president. And Abdul Kalam was involved in the preparation. He had a lot of effort for preparing missiles. That is why was also known as
Vijay.
So thank you. You go, then we group one, you come. You do your last question.
What was the name of his mother?
Please, students, you go through the second paragraph. What was the name of his mother? Yes. Give them the book, they will say.
brothers and sisters, including his mother and father.
APJ Abdul Kalam had four brothers, including his father.
APJ Abdul Kalam has three brothers, including him, they were four.
APJ Abdul Kalam has three brothers, and his mother and his father.
And one more sister. Sister.
APJ Abdul Kalam had his parents, that is mother and father, and his three brothers along with a sister.
APJ Abdul Kalam has three brothers, including him, they were four, and one more sister. So they were five. And he was the youngest one. APJ Abdul Kalam was not elder. He was the youngest. Then,
who were his ancestors?
Go through the paragraph, read the lines. Who were his ancestors? Mahindra.
His ancestors were the traders and the landowners.
Again?
His ancestors were the traders and the landowners.
His ancestors were the traders and
landowners.
His ancestors were wealthy traders. They have more wealth. They were rich. They were rich people. They were rich traders. They have more money. And they have also more land. So they were wealthy traders and landowners. They have also, they own more land, more acres of land. So they were wealthy traders and land. Okay?
Then, what was the condition of his family?
What was the condition of his family? Who can say? Ranjita.
The condition of the family, the condition of the family was very poor. Sit down, Sundar.
The condition of the family was very poor.
What did he do to supplement his family income?
What did he do to support his family members? Because his family was poor, in poor condition.
He sold newspapers to supplement his income.
Yes. Anybody?
He had to sell newspapers to supplement his family.
Yes. Let's see.
He sold newspapers to supplement his family's income.
Yes.
He sold
newspapers.
Newspapers to
supplement his family income.
Why do you think that his ancestral were very rich? And how they became poor? You read the second paragraph. Yes.
Yes. What is the second part? paragraph about. The second paragraph is about his family background.
What is the second paragraph about? The second paragraph was about his childhood and his family background. His childhood and his family background. The first paragraph was about his award and achievement, and the second paragraph was about his family background. Now, thank you, go. And you come, Miss Rani. Yes, you also. You come.
When did he burn? When did he burn?
Go through the book. When did he burn?
He was born on 15th October 1921.
He was born. You tell.
Dr. Abdul Kalam was born on 15th October in 1931.
Mosque. Yes,
thank you. Why his father owned a prairie? his father owned a ferry?
Why his father owned a ferry?
Various books, the child's growth, holistic growth, and he has wrote about a child's education, and he has focused about how a child should be creative, the creative side of a child should be brought out by the teacher.
Very good. And you come.
APJ Abdul Kalam was a very practical man. He used to visit people and used to participate in all the works, and he was a very grounded person.
Thank you. Mahendra, you come.
APJ Abdul Kalam was the people's president because people loved him, and he also used to visit different schools and different colleges. He used to like
school children.
He liked to spend time with the children, and he was also a great teacher also.
Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was the late president of our country, and he was the first scientist president of our country.
Very good, very good. You go. I had a privilege to see Dr. Abdul Kalam when I was at Sambalpur.
Yes.
And at that time, he was came to Sambalpur Jilla School.
Yes.
And so many school children were there, and we teachers were also there, and he used to ask many questions, invite many questions from school children, and our school children, they asked many questions to different children of different schools. They were together, and Abdul Kalam gave answer of all the questions of all the students. And the most important part of his life, which I like, he was a distinguished person, no doubt, but the most important person of his life, he was a very sincere, dedicated teacher. And he wanted to die at the time of his teaching. He had a desire to die in classroom or while teaching, while giving any lecture. Because lecturing or giving teaching was his hobby, favorite part of his life. So I like that. Okay? Thank you. Then the questions, third page questions. Yes. You can come.
Do I need to write it?
No, like you just
choose the correct answer from.
Listen carefully, attentively.
Choose the correct answer from the choices given below. The full name of Abdul Kalam was. Of A. Abdul Kalam. B. Abul Jainulabdin Abdul. C. Abul Pakir Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam. D. Pakir Abdul Kalam.
And the right answer is option C. Abul Pakir Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam.
Thank you. The right answer is C. Abdul Fakir, Abul Jainuddin Abdul Kalam.
The right answer is Abul Fakir Jainuddin Abdul Kalam. The second question. He was known as option A. President of India. B. Scientist. C. The Missile Man of India. D. None of them. None of the ever.
I'll just put it on.
The question is, he was known as option A, President of India, B, Scientist, C, the Missile Man of India, D, none of the above.
Option C, Missile Man.
Option C is the correct one. Yes,
option C, but then he was also known as the president of.
He was known as. That means he was described as. He is the president of India. He was the president, but he was known as being this president. He was known as missile man. He was the scientist. No doubt, he was the president. But he was known as.
Major B.
Yes.
He was known as the missile man of
India.
Question C. Kalam was born in option A, 15th October 1931, B, 2nd October 1951, C, 5th September 1932, D, 14th November 1940.
Ms. Sujita.
Option A, 15th October 1931.
Thank you.
Very good. Next question.
He became President of India in the year 2002, option A, that is option A, and B, 2005, C, 1999, D, 2010.
Rajita.
Option A, 2002.
Must. Must. Must.
Option A, who owned land. Option 2, a religious man who lived square in a mosque. Option number 3, to wear something, to improve something. Option number 5, not related to army force. Imam.
The person.
A person who lives prayer in the mosque. A person who
religious man. Religious man who lives prayer in a mosque.
Thank you. Group 3.
Krishna.
Huan Sang was a Chinese pilgrim.
Pilgrim.
He came to
India.